This is Progatron, different perspectives on progressive music. I am your host, David L. Gordon. This show is dedicated to my old friend, Richard Moses, a.k.a. Dick Bradley. Well, Richard used to be the classical, I guess he was the head of the classical department at CFSI. And sometimes he would get me to fill in for him. And I never got to do this show, where I combine classical music and rock music. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. Tonight we're just going to play the stuff that works, and we're going to start out with Keith Emerson. So hang on to your hats. This is going to be an interesting clash of cultures, clash of music, and I think it works sometimes. Let's see. Thank you. That was The Nice doing Symphony No. 6 by Tchaikovsky, the third movement. That was Tchaikovsky's last work, and it's interesting from the perspective of a rock band taking on a classical piece and boistering themselves with an orchestra in the background and taking a symphonic approach. Well, we're going to do that again, but this time the band is doing an original song called Salisbury from their second album. And I think this is a really good example of combining rock and classical. This is Uriah Heep.
Drives us to one more. Oh, girl of all my dreams, please tell me. special glow. Something drawing me to where I do not know. I never really thought that I would lose myself. Now I'm going faster than anybody else. You move without a sound and touch me with your hand. Just like the waves that fondle every little grain of sand. This thing we're gonna do is just for you and me.
That was Uriah Heep, a group that's still around today. That was David Byron on lead vocals, and it was from their second album, Salisbury. That was the title track. Great example of a rock band embracing classical sound. The next band, well, it was the first time that a lot of us heard that particular thing of classical and rock meeting. And the song is called Nights in White Satin, from an album called Days of Future Past. Moody Blues is the group, and I think this is like going back to the basics of the concept of a rock band embracing classical music. I'm sure Richard would be proud.
Never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send. Beauty I always meet with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore. 'Cause I love you, huh? Yes, I love you, huh? I love you. Gazing at people, some hand in hand. Just what I'm going through, I can't understand. Some try to tell me thoughts they cannot defend. Just what you want to be, you will be. And I love you. I love you. ever reaching the end. Letters I've written never mean to send. The beauty I always miss with these hands before. Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore. 'Cause I love you, huh? Yes, I love you, huh? Yeah. Oh,
I think the next song would be the most upsetting one for my old friend and mentor, Richard. You see, this is Siegel Schwal Band and the San Francisco Symphony conducted by Seiji Ozawa. Now, it might sound a little bit awkward, and there are parts where the blues band and the classical orchestra clash, but this piece is not one of them. This is the third piece of the three pieces for blues band and symphony, written by William Russo. And later on, Corky Laing will go on to be a chamber blues guy, and he will transform blues music in the future. But at this point, this clash, this coming together of genres, I think is most fascinating. And that's why I chose, because of Corky's harp playing, I chose to call it PhilHarmonica.
Thank you.
And now we have another group, Procol Harum, that used orchestration very early in its career. I think specifically around the album A Salty Dog. Later, the band changed a little bit, and Gary Brooker decided to do more ponderous pieces with different musicians, and he did a great album called Grand Hotel. These next songs are from that album. Recorded in Los Angeles at the Hollywood Bowl.
night we sleep on silken sheets. We drink fine wine and eat rare meat on carousel and gambling stakes. Our fortunes speak and dissipate. Candlelight and chandelier, it's silver plate and crystal clear. But it's serenade and sigh. The nights we stay at Hotel Grand, tonight we dine at Hotel Ritz, a golden dish with every wish. It's mirrored walls and velvet drapes, dry champagne bursting grape, Toba Sol in the morning, Raffia Rose and the waiters dance on fingertips. The nights we dine at Hotel Ritz.
Wine and dine, dash to slept in the sky. Early morning, pinch and bite. See, French girls always like to fight. But it's 7, 8 and Saraband. Tonight's we stay.
The crowds have gone home.
stars sailed away. Our flowers and feathers scarring this weapon. Our poems and letters have turned to deception.
Renaissance is a group that really doesn't get enough credit. Annie Haslam, the fabulous front person with that band, and they totally embraced the symphonic sound, epic songs that they did. This is one of my favorites. It's recorded at Carnegie Hall. It was from an album called Turn of the Cards. It's an ode to that great land east of the European border, on the other side of that digital wall currently. The song is entitled Mother Russia.
Freedom's Renaissance with Orchestra at Carnegie Hall. What a great tune. Eh? You know, I'm not a musician like Rod or Mr. McGee or Randall. And I heard Randall talking about the Devil's Note, how it was forbidden and all that stuff. I tried trumpet when I was a kid, but I really don't know much about the structure of music and how it works that way. I know it intuitively. I know it in my head when I hear things. But here we go. This is, I think, one of the finest representations of what we're talking about tonight. Pink Floyd was in a kind of a transition period, and it was far from doing the pop songs that it later did. But Adam Hart Mother stands as a giant epic testament to the theme of our show tonight. I think it's one of the great pieces. So here we are, Pink Floyd, Adam Hart Mother.
Thank you.
Our next selection is a somewhat unusual opening in that the record that it's based on by the same artist was released just a few years before as a first album. This is Michael Oldfield's third album, and it's actually a reworking of his first album, Tubular Bells, with David Bedford conducting the orchestra. Here's an example of an established rock piece being redone by an orchestra, and I think done in a very slick, polished fashion. So I hope you enjoy the orchestral version of Tubular Bells. You're listening to Progatron.
Thank you.
I have a friend who listens to this show, and they sent me this great documentary about Frank Zappa's sources, his inspirations for the album Freakout. There's a lot of classical in there. There's doo-wop, there's blues, there's rock and roll, there's rock, there's all kinds of stuff. But the interesting part for me was Frank's take on classical, that he was so interested in classical. And I'm talking about the more abstract, interesting musicians like Varese and Stravinsky. And you can hear it in Frank's music. Well, the last album that Frank really did was called The Yellow Shark. And he orchestrated some of his older pieces and some newer pieces. The one we're going to play tonight is Uncle Meat. And this is great. This is Frank conducting from the album The Yellow Shark. That's it for tonight's show. I want to thank you for listening to tonight's Progatron. And I want to invite you to tune in again next time. We have four hosts on Progatron. We have Randall Liberon, Mr. Bobby McGee, and of course, Roderick Shulbrade. So stay tuned and catch all the shows. And as Richard used to say, have a care.